Favorite road trip song?
It was my favorite road trip song.
Where are we going?
We're going on a road trip!
Road tripping. We've never been on a road trip.
Except for Europe. We just established that a road trip means that you don't just drive from point A to point B. You see many places on the way.
And you have a purpose. No, you don't have a purpose. That's the whole point, right?
Like, you're just doing it for fun. Like, right. You don't have to do it for work or whatever. Or does everyone know that? And we just established this in 2019. But we are going, originally we thought Santa Barbara and then LA. We thought about doing like Malibu, the coast too, but then there's this Danish town.
We're going to Solvang, which is a Danish city before Santa Barbara. So we're going to Santa Barbara, we're stopping in Solvang. And we're gonna eat Danish food. And I'm excited about that. And then we're gonna go to Santa Barbara and stay for 2 days. Then we're going to take the Highway 1 to LA from there and stay for a couple of days. And then we're going to take the dreaded, awful, horrible, not good, very bad drive back up to San Francisco.
On Sunday.
Let's
not think about that.
Is McDonald's what you envisioned when we went on a road trip? Why are we here?
I was enthralled by their salads. And Adam's making fun of me. Salads.
Do salads in cups?
Yeah, like large cups and then dressings on top and then it would go then you would shake it.
At McDonald's?
Yeah. I never got one, but I remember.
We had never heard of that.
1443?
Well, you couldn't have done that worse. You got this.
That doesn't look bad.
I got ladle and leaf yesterday for the first time for lunch. And this looks actually better. Mm.
At college in Denmark, me and my friend Magnus would go into like a random class and borrow my English teacher's car. Then we would drive to McDonald's.
Yeah, only in Denmark.
And then we would buy 10 double cheeseburgers for lunch. Yeah. We did it a couple of times. Normally we wouldn't get 10, but when they were on sale and they were $1, well, in Danish money, they were less than $1 actually, I think. We would get 10 double cheeseburgers and share. So we would eat 5 each, obviously, but 5 double cheeseburgers. It was a good day for everybody. Let's see if it's as good as I remember. Nope.
This is exactly what I was craving. I'm impressed. McDonald's, good job on your salad. Do you think they made it with love?
Made with love since 19... Is it everything you dreamt of? Are you comfortable?
Are you driving?
I'm driving.
I get to be comfortable. When I was driving, I was only driving.
You know what? Cruise control and lane assist is basically autopilot.
He thinks he has a Tesla, but he fucking doesn't.
It like, with lane assist, it'll like ping pong between the lanes.
Yeah, which is not what you're supposed to do. It's like in case you fall asleep, not just assume the car's gonna drive for you.
It's the same as a Tesla, pretty much.
Rover.
A Tesla Rover. Look, ping pong. Ping pong.
No. Both hands on the wheel.
No hands on the wheel?
Both. Adam's been driving for 7 minutes and he's already delusional and like trying to find things to do wildly. I drove for 3 hours. Zero complaints.
I'm not complaining. I'm just multitasking.
No, that's your way. Men can't multitask.
No, I'm the best fucking multitasker in the world.
Sure.
Sullivan. Except it's been fake Denmark. Sullivan shoe store. You get clocks? Crocs and clocks. Welcome to Solang. Sylvia's on her phone, not enjoying Danish culture in America.
I'm posting you being a tourist.
Oh, I'm excited for this.
Wait, can you get a picture of me? Oh, there's the Napoleon.
Oh, there you go, there's the Napoleon. Thank you. Oh, you can't really get everything. It's a very, very, very subtle, tiny little biscuit.
And this coffee mug. It's like
so, in fact, it's so authentic that it's spent the last 6 weeks in a shipping container from Denmark.
So our theory is that it's that authentic.
It's that authentic. Traveled. It's journeyed from Denmark. Do you think there's another bakery that would have authentic stuff? We can go have a second coffee.
Maybe more than this one. It's probably. It was so cute on the outside.
This one? And the windmill. So it does look very legit and Danish, except not even Denmark looks this Danish.
Right, exactly.
It's like everything is Denmark, Denmark, Denmark. It's like a who's who of Danish industrial design. And it all of my dreams are about to come true. Sylvia always complains that I love condiments so much. Maybe it's a cultural thing. Stalker. There's a guy who was at the first bakery with us. Then we went to a second bakery to look if it was more authentic, and then he was there eating cake as well. Now we went to the sausage place, and now he just walked in too. So, oh, it's hot dog time. Yeah, it's hit red, it's very pink, but okay. $78.
We ate everything
there was to offer. Do you want to go down Copenhagen Drive? It should be called Imposter Drive. How else do we milk Denmark? Oh yeah, wait. Shakespeare wrote that story about that Danish guy Hamlet. So we haven't put that name on anything yet. So.
Yep.
Hamlet was Danish. So let's just put Hamlet on a windmill and call it a day. That looks exactly like where my mom lives in Denmark. That pretty much sums up this whole city.
They need our consensus on...
Right. Bye-bye fake Denmark. So, in consensus, in appearances, they did a good job.
I was just saying, it seems like 100 years ago, there was actually Danish people here, and they built this place, and now it's like they've abandoned it, and non-Danish people are running it, and it's not as authentic.
It's just gone to shit.
Still really cute, absolutely.
It looks very, very, it looks like all of Denmark is like compressed into one town square.
Right.
Which is cool. But, yeah, that's it.
But of course, you can't expect it to look like Denmark and like taste like Denmark.
And taste like Denmark and feel like Denmark, then it would be Denmark.
Yeah, I mean.
if it walks like a duck and it quacks like a duck.
Quacks?
If it walks like a duck and it quacks like a duck, it's probably a duck.
Except it didn't quack like a duck.
It walked like a duck, but it definitely didn't quack like a duck. We made it to Santa Barbara.
Before sunset. Literally walk on the beach. Except we're on.
We're walking on almost the beach. We're gonna go find wine tasting. And then we're gonna find
sushi.
We're gonna find some sushi. Look at them, they're changing out the titles like olden times.
Damn.
Damn. Can you reach that?
You're not
like Michael Jordan, like me.
You're like, what color?
De la Guerra. Streets in Spain. El Paseo.
What do you remember when you opened? I was so close to the other. I was hooked. Oh, dreamy.
No mas. Ready to horse around?
It's been 24 years.
Hey, friend.
With no bullet.
Okay, now this is Shelby, and she will stay in the back all the time. Okay, don't let her advance. Oh, okay. I was ready to run. Nope.
Did you enjoy your horse experience?
Oh, I want a horse.
You should get two in San Francisco. That would be great.
San Francisco, I want a horse.
Hey guys.
Thank you.
You betcha. How was it?
That's fun. Great. Pick one. We're the only people in the restaurant. We couldn't get a table for dinner. We sure as hell got one planned.
Outside. There's people inside.
Oh my god.
So that had a clear day, so that's why most people are in bed.
Cheddar chips. I mean,
yeah.
Crack. We got off the menu duck.
I know. But we were like, please eat it.
We got the secret duck. Mandatory pictures.
I know. And this lunch has been my favorite part of this trip so far.
That is the most Caesar salad I've ever seen.
A prawn Caesar salad is like one of my favorite things.
I wish you filled my wine glass more.
That looks like a child's sippy cup. That's a good wine.
Oh.
Yeah. This is what beach dreams are made of.
That's fresh prawns. Mm-hmm. That is the best fish and chips I've ever had in my life.
What? Oh, the whole thing. That was mine.
So good. Fresh halibut. I mean, you don't have to eat the chips. Because that fish. Mm. Oh, shit, it's good.
You ready for an awful photo shoot?
Are you ready to do some wine tasting?
Consume.
And drinking. And horseback riding.
And horses.
But also eating and drinking.
That's my least favorite. It was very, very good wine, I will say.
Good job.
Yeah.
I was here with Redken a couple of months ago, and it was so good, and I told Adam all about it, and he said since we were here, we should go back in so that he could try it.
What do you think of Santa Barbara?
That was great. I thought it was sad that we kind of got the two gloomiest days of the year. And today we woke up and it was like beautiful and sunny.
It's true.
But that lunch at Belmont?
Yeah, that was sick.
Yeah, that made the trip.
I'm just gonna say. It looks, I think the pier and all that, it kind of looks like Hawaii. I think it's the closest you can get to Hawaii outside of Hawaii, I think.
I disagree. I don't think it, I mean, it's a beach, sure.
But it had the mountains in the background with the fog and all that stuff, kind of like Hawaii.
The fog?
It had like clouds with real mountains.
That's not what I get in Hawaii. I don't get fog.
You get beach and then you have mountains in the background.
Adam's opinion, he thought he was in Hawaii, so.
Right.
Good on you.
Yep.
I think Santa Barbara is absolutely beautiful, and I think it's a cool town. Like, I feel
At cool bars.
Like, in my 50s, I'd want to live in a beautiful Santa Barbara house. But, yeah, and then, of course, it has a big college community.
And then we got the car washed for the last stretch of the drive, and now we're in L.A. almost. We're in Ventura now, and then we're going to drive through Malibu, and then check into our hotel in L.A.
In 4 short hours, we're here.
7 miles in 4 hours.
Exactly.
Took long enough.
What, the drive?
It looks like caramel. If it smells like caramel and it tastes like caramel.
But it's actually peanut butter.
It walks like a duck, quacks like a duck.
It doesn't quack.
Quack. Oh, delicious.
Wanna hold your hand? Figs or olives?
Both.
Both? Are you excited for brunch?
So excited.
And we're waiting for our friends who are notoriously late.
And Adam was so worried, we're 5 minutes early. And we left.
I am always punctual. To the fault, and everybody else always late.
It is a fault. It's a huge fault. Are you gonna have a mimosa?
Absolutely not.
You cannot do alcohol for brunch.
Yeah. The only problem was receiving nothing. Every time you told my opinion was wrong.
If anyone wants to try this, this is alright.
Cheers to lunch, brunch.
I have alcohol. Am I the only one that's drinking alcohol? Cheers.
Are you done shopping?
I haven't shopped one bit.
Yeah, it's just couldn't buy anything.
The last LA summer.
It's brunch, but. And it's raining in LA. It's like the most rain we've ever had in LA.
Did you have fun?
I did. Did you?
I did. Are you ready to move to LA?
There's a lot of moving parts to that decision. I can turn on the camera and ask. Okay. Expect a different answer. Cheers.
That's a bomb ass gluten free bread. It really is. Pretty good.
Is that okay with you guys?
Good enough to move to LA for? Maybe.
monsooning.
Great weather we've had on this drive. Do you love it?
I love it.